Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. Okay, so this week I'll be showing you how to animate text using masks and text properties. It really saves time when you need to hide your text behind graphics, shapes, lines, or just an area in general on your screen. Let's get started. Let's right click, new, solid, let's make it white. Now if you hit Control T, you can bring up your text creator. So let's just create some text here. So 7-Minute AE Tutorials. A really neat plugin that I came across a while back, a friend of mine turned me on to it, and it's saved me a ton of time, is this Move Anchor Point. I'm going to put this in the comment section below, and you can drop it right into your script UI panels, which is in your program files, Adobe, whatever version you're using, support files, scripts, script UI panels. And the cool thing about this is wherever you click on here, it's going to put your anchor point. And this goes for text layers, for images, for anything. So let's center it. And then in our align, let's center that as well. If you hit the quotes button, it brings up your guides. So let's do that. And then let's create another solid. Let's make this one black. And basically, we're just going to create a line here. Now, you can create a line in a number of ways. This is one really, really fast way of doing this. If you uncheck this, make your Y 1 and your X 60. Let's move that down. Okay, so basically what we want to do is we want to move this text from below the line to above it, but we want everything underneath the line to be hidden. Now, we'll be adding elements using this animate option here. So let's animate the position. And as you see, it opens up an animator. It creates an animator right here with a position, range selector. These are just various ways of animating this text. What we want to do before we do anything else is we want to Control D to duplicate the animator. So now we have animator 1 and animator 2. Let's open that up so we see the position. The animator 2 position, that's where we're going to end up. Animator 1 position is where we're going to begin. So let's take this animator 1 position and move it right below the line. And animator 2, we'll just leave right there. Okay, so in order to animate this text, if you open up range selector 1, that's going to be the one that's going to be controlling the movement of this text. We want to offset 0. That's going to be our beginning. Go about a second. And then increase it to 100. And basically what we have is very simple. Just now, the reason why it's animating it by the characters is because under the advanced option under range selector 1, it defaults to characters based on characters. If we change that to words, we see it moves the words one at a time. And also we can do it by line. Let's change this keyframe to an easy in. Go to the graph editor like we did last week, and let's pull this over so it kind of eases into it like that. And it eases in. Now, if you click on offset, it highlights all the keyframes in here. Now, hit Control C for copy. Go to where you want it to animate out. So we'll just say right here, Control V. And so we have the same exact two keyframes. Now, watch this. With these two highlighted, if you right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes. Watch this. Animates in, animates out. And it's the same exact animation, same speed and everything. So now how do we hide this text? So if you hit Control R, it brings up your rulers. Now let's grab right here, pull it down, kind of zoom in. We want it to be right in the middle of this line. Okay, now let's grab our rectangle tool and draw around our text. And so there we go. So now it's hidden. Comes in and comes out. Now, the reason why I'm using these animator options is because if you use the transform properties and you have a mask, whenever you move the position, the mask moves with it. Okay, so by using these animator controls, the mask will stay right where it is. The last two episodes I've gone over shape layers using transitions and a variety of things, and you can save those as presets. Well, in the same way, you can save this animation as a preset. And I'll show you how to do that. So what we want to do is you want to copy everything in your text option. You want to go ahead and if you want, you can select this mask as well and that will come in. Let's choose animation, save animation preset. And this is going to open up your documents, Adobe After Effects 2015 user presets. Now, as I mentioned last time, you can create these folders in here and these will be reflected in your After Effects project. So as you can see right here, we have effects, graphs and charts, shape layers, transitions, trap code particular. And over in our project, we also see that we have the same folder structure. So let's add a new folder and call it text animation. go into there and let's name this up by character. Hit enter. Okay, so let's get rid of our animator one and two and also our mask. So now we're back to just the text. If we go over to animation presets, user presets, text animations, and there it is. If you click on a layer and press I, it brings you to the beginning. O brings you to the out or the end. So let's press I, bring in this preset, and it'll drop whatever keyframes you have wherever your marker is. Click U to check that out, and there we go. So it came in with this preset as well as this mask, as you can see. Now, this trick can also be used with plugins that already come with After Effects. So let's get rid of these animators here. So if we go to our effects and presets, just type in drop in, and then we have drop in by character. Let's go to the beginning here. Drop in by character, look at our keyframes. Let's make it about like that. Okay, so this is basically the same concept as what I was going over. Basically, this position here, this is going to be your beginning position. So let's move it down to here. And as we see, it moves up. So you can use these plugins that are already included in After Effects. And again, if you copy this, paste it, right click, reverse keyframes, same exact thing. So there you go. I'll save this After Effects project and post it in the comments below. I hope this helped you out. This is a new channel and I'd love to do a lot more of these. So please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything in particular you'd like to see. Thanks everybody. See you next time.